Hello students, today I am going to discuss about detailed estimation of road of the subject estimation and cost evaluation part 2. I am Soumyakanta Sahu, lecturer in civil engineering department, government polytechnic Jagatsinghpur. So let us start our topic. So what is estimation? Before construction of any structure, we need to determine the quantity and the cost. So quantity can be measured in meter cube, meter square, kilograms, etc. and cost is generally computed in rupees. So in this chapter, we are basically going to determine the quantities of earthwork in road construction. So next is the ground level and formation line. So we can see here, this is the shape of the ground level. So you can see this is an uneven surface. So we have to first level the surface. How can we level the surface? So we have to make this level a flatter one. So you can see this is formation line. It is a flatter surface. So we have to reduce the height. So we can see it is the raised part. We have to reduce its height to this level, and it is a shallow part. We have to increase its height. So how can you do that? By cutting operation. Ame dekhi paruche eta uncha portion se uncha portion ko amku ei level janke formation line janke amku cut kariyaku padibo, and एटा हमर नीचा पोर्शन टिके अछि और सैलो पोर्शन वी हैव टू फिल इट. आमे माटी फिल करी करी ए लेवल को अप टू द फॉर्मेशन लेवल आनिया को पड़िबो, सो दैट आवर ग्राउंड लेवल कैन बी ए फ्लैटर वन और ऑफ द फॉर्मेशन लेवल द लेवल. सो द लेवल कैन बी ऑफ द फॉर्मेशन लेवल. सो हियर वी कैन सी दैट फॉर्मेशन लेवल इज द इमेजिनरी लाइन ड्रॉन टू लेवल द ग्राउंड सर्फेस. सो द क्वांटिटी रिक्वायर इन कटिंग एंड द क्वांटिटी रिक्वायर इन फिलिंग we have to determine here. Here we have to determine the quantity, how much quantity we have cut here, and here how much quantity we have filled here to make this level up to this surface. So next let us see the section of a road. So we can see this is the section of a road. This is an isometric view of the road. So here we need to determine the quantities of earthwork in embankment. So this is embankment. Embankment is the road level. The height of this embankment is above the natural ground surface. So this here we have to construct our road level. So we can see this has more height than the ground level. Natural, this is the our natural ground surface. We have the formation level here. It is at a higher elevation. So the bottom line is the ground level, and the top line, the top line here we can see that it is the formation level. So how can you, we have to rise the level up to the formation level. एटी आम देखी पारे आमर ग्राउंड लेवल टे तौ लेवल अच्छी आमको रोड कंस्ट्रक्शन करार अच्छी ऊपर लेवल ताल आमको फास्ट काम करार अच्छी बाय फिलिंग. आम माटी ए जगार फिल करी अप टू ए लेवल आने को पड़ा. वी हाव टू फिल इट विथ द अर्थ एंड वी हाव टू कंपैक्ट इट अप टू दिस पोर्सन. आफ्टर दिस पोर्सन वी कैन ले आवर रोड्स. सो हाउ टू कंप्यूट द क्वांटिटी. क्वांटिटी इज नथिंग बट द वॉल्यूम, टोटल वॉल्यूम रिक्वायर्ड टू फिल दिस पोर्सन. So we have to find its volume. The quantity is cross sectional area into the length of the section. We'll discuss about it a later. First let us see the dimensions of this section. Here L is the length of the span or the section. Here this is the length of the road section. B is the top width of the formation width. Here this is the top width or the formation width above which we have to construct our roads. It is constant for the whole section. So you can see, let us assume this is just the section top width. This is the B, it is constant. You can see this is constant for the whole length L, like this. Here the top width or the B is constant. Next, this is sloping portion. We have two slopes here, one in and it is the second portion. The slope is S:1. So for S horizontal we have one unit vertical. Next let us see this section. इफ यू कट एट एनी पोर्सन, जदि आम सेक्शन को एट एनी पोर्सन कट करुचे तो क्रॉस सेक्शन आमको गोटे ट्रापिजम सेप देखा जाऊँ. दिस इज द ट्रापिजम सेक्शन. से ट्रापिजम सेक्शन रो सर्टेन डेप्थ रहा, सर्टेन टॉप विड्थ रहा, ठीक अच्छे. देन हियर वी कैन सी एट द फ्रंट एंड, लेट अस सी एट द फ्रंट सेक्शन वी कैन सी इफ यू कट हियर इट इज द ट्रापिजम सेक्शन एंड हियर इज ऑल्सो ए ट्रापिजम सेक्शन एट द बैक एंड. at any section. Also, you can see at the mid portion, it is the middle portion at a length L by 2, it is of some depth. So here at the top part, we can see D1 is the depth. D1 is the depth at the top trapezium, and D2 is the depth at the previous or the back trapezium. So we can see both the depths are different. Here it is D1 and it is D2. So these depths are varying. Amar depth eti D1 achi aur D2 achi. Amar ei depth eti vary kori kori jauchi. In the length L, it is varying. So we have to assume that the depth is varying linearly. So amku jodi ko bhi portion re depth bahar kori rachi, then we can use our mathematical formula, that is linear interpolation, or by mean or average we can find the depth. So let us try to find out the depth at the middle section. At the middle section, we can find the depth by average. We can average the top depth and the previous or the back depth. So at the middle section, that is D, it is D1 plus D2 by 2. It is the average. It is mathematically, it is the average. So now we have to find the cross-sectional area into the length. So we have to find the cross-sectional area of this middle trapezium. We have to find that the cross-sectional area of this trapezium, and we have to multiply with the entire length of the section. Okay, so now let us try to find out the cross section. So this is the cross sectional area of the trapezium. See, this is our trapezium. The top width is given as B. It is the depth or the mean depth. We have already computed that. The side slope is given S:1. So for S unit horizontal, we have to put 1 unit vertical. So you can see this trapezium is the combination of this rectangular part and two triangular part. We know the area of the rectangle is length times B. So length is here, top width B, and the depth is D. So the area of the rectangle will be B into D. And the rail, let us find the area of this right angle triangle. It is right angle. We have depth equals to D. We need to find the base. So to find the base, we need this. So this says for S horizontal, we have 1 unit vertical. So here we have vertical D units. So for D units, we have to, there will be S into D times horizontal. So similarly, this is also the same section. It will be HD. For D vertical, we have HD horizontal. So area of this triangle will be half into base we have just found out, HD, and depth is D. So area of one triangle will be SD square, half HD square. So area of two triangles will be 2 into half SD square. So it will be half HD square. So total area of the triangle is, first the area of the area of this rectangle plus 2 times area of this triangle. So it will be BD plus HD square. We can see that there. So after finding the cross section, we will multiply with the length. We have seen this in the previous slide. So next, let us try to find out the area of the side slopes. The areas, let us try to find out. This is the side slope. We can see this is the side slope. Also, we have two side slopes. Here one part, and opposite to this, there will be another side slope. We have to calculate the area. So let us calculate it. So this is the same section, or this is the section of the road. So this area we need to calculate. For this, let us see, we know that this is the top width of the formation width, that is B. The depth here is D1. At the top one, it is D1, the depth is D1, and at the bottom it is D2, or at the back the depth is D2. At the center portion, or at the middle portion, the depth will be D. It is the mean depth, we know that. So to find this, let us try to find out this. It is PS, the length of PS, we need to find that. So for D1, the slope is constant for the whole length, that is s is to 1, it is constant. So for d1 vertical, we have s times d1 horizontal. So this is a right angle triangle and this is the hypotenuse. So we can get it by Pythagoras theorem, that is perpendicular square plus base square. Here the perpendicular is d1 and the base is sd1. So the final value will be d1 under root 1 plus s square. So this is the length of this PS. It is the length of PS is d1 under root 1 plus s square. Here like this we can calculate, like it is the depth d2 and this base will be s d2. Similarly, this will be this length, that is qr. This qr will be d2 under root 1 plus s square. So you can see this slant portion is varying, its depth is varying, and this depth depends on the parameter d. The depth, this slant height depends on this depth. So similarly we can found at this ame maji portion re bhi depth bahar kori paiga. Similarly, so it will be d, the vertical height will be d, the horizontal height will be sd. So this will be d times this length xy, this will be d times 1 plus s square. So after finding this we have to multiply it with the entire length to get the area of one side slope. We know that we have two side slope, here it is, and opposite to this we have another side slope. So total areas will be, for one we can see one side, for this area it is l times d into under root 1 plus s square. For two sides it will be 2 times 2 into l into d into under root 1 plus s square. So next let us try to see a numerical problem. So this is a numerical problem. Here this says RL of the ground level along the center line of a road is given. So for 300 meters we have given the RL is nothing but the reduced level, or the height of the ground level measured from the datum. Amar datum mane zero mark, 0 meter ru kete meter upare amar ground surface achi measure hochi seita amar RL. So RL amar deichi at 0 meters deichi, 30 meters deichi, 60 meters, up to 300 meters length jake amar RL deichi. So at 0 meter is the starting point and 300 meter is the end point. So आम देखिपे प्रति 30 मीटर इंटरवल रे आमर आरएल दे. तो लेट अस ट्राई टू प्लॉट दिस. एट 0 मीटर द आरएल ऑफ द ग्राउंड इज 105 मीटर्स. सो लेट अस अज्यूम द बॉटम पोर्शन इज द डैटम. सो विथ लेवल टू दिस वी हैव टू कंस्ट्रक्ट. सो फर्स्ट हाइट इज 105 मीटर्स, दिस एट 0 पॉइंट. आफ्टर 30 मीटर्स द हाइट इज, और द आरएल इज 105.6. after 30 meters it will be 105.4, then 105.9, then 105.4, 105.3, 105, 104.1, 104.6, 104, 103.3. So approximately I have drawn the points. So these are the points where the RL is known, or we can say this is the stations. These are the stations. So we have total 11 stations. We can see total there is 11 stations for 300 meters. We have the horizontal distance between two stations is 300 meter. So this is the height measured from the datum. So we have plotted the RL of different points. To know the shape of the ground, let us try to join these points. So this is the picture of our ground profile. Ame dekhi paruche amar ground profile is uneven shape. Amar shape yaro uneven achi, to ya pare ame amar gaadi motor chalei pariyani. To first we have to label the surface. We know that we have to label by using the formation label. So see the next part of the question. It is given the formation label is to be given at 0 meters. At the 0 meters or at the starting point here, the formation level is to be provided 107 meters. So it is 105 meters. The formation level provided here, it is 107 meters. Okay, it is higher. We can see the height of the formation level is at higher level. Then, and the road is in downward gradient. So the gradient of the roads then decreases. It is in the 1 in 150 ratio, it decreases. So ratio 1 in 150 up to 120 meter. So we know this is the, it is 30 meter, sorry, up to 3 we know the total ground level distance is 300 meter. So up to 120 meters, 30, it will be 60, this will be 90, and this will be 120. Up to this, the gradient is 120, 1 in 150, up to 120 meters, okay. Then the gradient changes after this, the gradient changes to 1 in 100. So we will see that what is gradient. The formation width is nothing but it is B. So B is given here 10 meter. And the side slope is given, that is S is 1 is here, S is 2. For 2 horizontal, we have 1 vertical. Draw the L section. L section is the longitudinal section of the road and the cross section. And we need to prepare the estimate of earthwork. So let us try to see. This is 1 in 150 means for 150 meter horizontal, we have to provide 1 meter vertical. So here we can see between two stations, the horizontal distance is 30 meter. So for 30 meters, we have to see the change in vertical distance. So for 1 meter, it will be 1 by 150 and for 30 meters, it will be 1 by 150 into 30, that is 1 by 5 or 0.2 meters. So we can see for a distance of 30 meters, the vertical height is changing 0.2 meters. The changing means here it is decreasing. As we can see, this is the downward gradient in 1 in 150. So let us try to plot it. We know that for 30 meter length of the section, we have to decrease our vertical height by 0.2 units. So we have to start from here. It is the formation level at the starting position. It is 107 meters. So after 30 meters here, we have to decrease the height by 0.2. So it will be 107 minus 0.2. That will be 106.8 meters. It will continue up to 120 meters. Up to 120 meters, it will continue by decreasing 0.2, it will continue. So after 30 meters, it will be 106.8 minus 0.2, that will be 106.6, it will be 106.6 minus 0.2, it will be 106.4, and this will be 106.2. So up to 120 meter, we have seen our formation level decreases from 107 to 106.2 meters. But after that, we can see the gradient changes. So the gradients become steeper. It is 1 in 100. That means for 100 meter horizontal, we have to change 1 meter vertical. So for 30 meters horizontal, we have to see the value. Similarly, for 100 meter, it is 1 meter we have to change. So for 30 meters, it will be 1 by 100. Into 30, that will be 0.3 meters. So we can see that after 30 meters of horizontal, we have to decrease the vertical by 0.3 meters. So, and it will be up to the end point, up to 300 meter, from 120 meter to 300 meters, this will be the same, okay. Then from after 120 meter to 150 meter, we have to decrease by 0.3. So as the gradient will be same for entire,
So for this we have to decrease by 0.3. So 106.2 minus 0.3, that will be 105.9. So from this point we can calculate up to the last point by decreasing 0.3. So it will be 105.6
and so on up to the last point. So here we can see it is the similar diagram. The blue line here represents the ground level. Here I have drawn, this is the ground level, you can see, and the top portion we can, this is the formation line. So the formation line you can see decreases by 0.2 meter up to 120 meter, then by 0.3 meter up to end. Okay, so let us try to compute. So we can see between, we have to first find out between these two portion, the quantity we have to find between these two portion or these two portion, this section we have to find the quantity first. So we have seen how to calculate the quantity. Here the ground level is at 0.5 meters, so here it will be 0.5 meters. The formation level is 107 meters. Here the ground level is 105.6 meter and the formation level is 106.8 meters. So here we can see the difference. The difference is 107 minus 105, that will be 2 meters, and here the difference will be 106.8 minus 105.6, that will be 1.2 meters. So we can find the D, that means the average depth. We have already calculated. You can see B we have 10 meters given in the question. D for this section, this part, it will be 1.2. Then S is constant for the whole section. So we have calculated for 30 meters span, the quantity of filling will be 633.6 meter. So like this we can compute the table. So we can see the table, that is here the length is given. So each station 0, 30 meters, 60 meter, all the stations are given here. The difference between FL and GL, FL is the formation level, GL is the ground level. So difference between, this is the formation level and this is the ground level. So we have to compute all the difference of this formation level and ground level. So for the first we have seen that it is coming 2 meters, and for the after 30 meters it is 1.2 meters. So we can compute the difference up to the last, and we know how to find the mean depth, it is the average. So we can, this plus this by 2, it will be the average. 2 plus 1.2 by 2, it will be 1.6, like that. 1.2 plus 1.2 by 2, it will be 1.2, so and it is so on. This plus this by 2, it will be the average. So after finding the D, that is the important term, we can find the cross sectional area. B is constant for the whole, that is 10. D we can find by this, it will be the D, and S is constant. So we can find the cross sectional area for the entire portion, and the length between two stations, you know, it will constant, it is 30. So by multiplying these two columns we can find the quantity. So after finding that, the total quantity we can be summation of these all values. So we can see, as the formation level is the top portion, so we have to fill. Ame mati eti fill koriyaku padibo, a ground level ko a level jake height uthiyaku. तो फिल केते अमाउंट रे फिल करिया को पड़ियो ना एतिक अमाउंट 3546.45 मीटर क्यूब रे हमको फिलिंग करिया को पड़ियो अर्थ फिलिंग करिया को पड़ियो. नेक्स्ट वी कैन सी द कैलकुलेशन ऑफ एरिया ऑफ साइड स्लोप्स. सो साइड स्लोप हमको केते दबा को पड़ियो. साइड स्लोप वी हैव सीन दैट इट द एरिया ऑफ द साइड स्लोप इज 2 × L × D √1 + S². ऑल द कॉलम्स विल बी सेम, द लेंथ वी हैव सीन, द डेप्थ इज सेम. The mean depth we have to calculate, it is the average. The sloping depth, it is the formula we have seen in the previous slide. And L is constant for the whole section. So by multiplying these two, we can get the area. So after getting the area, we have to sum it. The total area will be 1308. So you can try the same type of problem here. So if any queries are there, you can mail me or you can WhatsApp me here. Thank you.
ଝିଅଟିଏ ତ ମାଟି, ଆମ ସାମାଜିକ ଓ ପାରିବାରିକ ଜୀବନର ମୂଳ କଥାଟିଏ। ସେମାନେ ଆଗକୁ ଗଲେ ଆଗକୁ ଯିବ ସଂସାର। ଆମ ଝିଅମାନେ ଆଉ ପୁଅଙ୍କଠୁ ପଛରେ ନାହାନ୍ତି। ଏବେ ତ ବଦଳି ଗଲାଣି ସମୟ। बदली गलानी जुग से झील मानू आहरी आग को नहीं आत्मनिर्भरशील और स्वावलंबी करने को ओडिशा सरकार सुदक्षा योजन सरकारी आईटीआई मध्यम संपूर्ण मागणारे जोगई देउछंती सबु प्रकार उत्कृष्ट मानर वैषयिक ज्ञानकौशल तालीम एबे आम झी रहिबे सबुठु आगरे सबुठु उपरे
मु सफल
मु कुशल
मु सुदक्षा
आमे सुदक्षा।